Hey guys, what's up? Pretty dark out there, huh? It is about 5:15 right now, and I turn some lights on. Be right back. Ooh, even that's dark. There we go. One second. Okay. So like I said, it is about 5:15 right now. I was really restless last night, and I just kept waking up, and the reason I kept waking up is last night was the first rain here in Southern California. It rained yesterday. It's expected to rain again today, and it's been kind of drizzly on and off all night. I guess this is going to be a homelessness, my experience video. I remember nights like this. In particular, I remember two nights like this, and it was a night that I stood at the, what's called the Ocean Park Community Center, OPCC, and I was waiting for a bus, a school bus, to go to the cold weather shelter. It was a little bit later in the year because those shelters don't open up until, I think it's around December they open up. So it was a little bit later in the year. It's kind of unusual for us to be having rain right now. Anyway, you have to stand outside. It was pouring down rain, and you would think something like an access center would open the doors and allow you to wait in the lobby while the bus for the shelter or until the bus for the shelter got there, especially since it had been raining really, really hard, and the first bus that came was over an hour and 45 minutes late. But that wasn't the case. We stood outside in the rain, and when the bus finally came, there were so many people waiting to get on that bus, and the bus driver did everything he could to accommodate as many people as he can, even allowing people to sit in the aisleway. I remember on the bus, people were squeezing three people to a seat just to try to get people out of the rain. And no one complained about three people in a seat. No one complained about people doubling up in that narrow row to try to get as many people out of the rain. I remember thinking to myself a couple of things. First, the streets were slick. The rain was really coming down. And I thought how dangerous it was for all of us to be on that bus like that. I thought about the bus driver possibly losing control of the bus flipping over, and all of us being either hurt or even killed. It was a very, very old school bus. Half the time the buses didn't run, they would break down. It was a dangerous situation. And other thoughts that I had was, here are homeless people who probably won't get a cot in this cold weather shelter at the armory, who will probably be served a spoiled meal, talked to like animals, and treated like garbage all night, doing everything they can to get other homeless people out of the rain. We got to the cold weather shelter, the West LA Armory, and again, it just started to pour. And we were ushered off the bus. So many people just started running toward the parking lot, hoping that they could just run inside the shelter. But when we got there, the National Guard had the gate closed and locked. So we all had to line up in the rain. Now, this was the last bus coming in, the very last bus. So it wasn't like the shelter had to prepare for us. It wasn't like we were the first people coming in and Volunteers of America who ran the shelter. It wasn't like they weren't there yet. They were already inside. There were people already inside. This was the last bus. So we stood there in that pouring down rain about 20 or 30 minutes before someone came out, unlocked the gate, and announced, "I only have 5 cots left." Everybody was just like, "What? I can't believe this." And people were thinking, you knew if you were like the 7th person in line, you weren't going to get in. So that was about maybe 30 people, possibly 40, because so many of us packed on that bus. So people started asking the bus driver, "Why did you come pick us up if you knew there was no room here? Why would you bring us here if you knew there was no room?" His response was, "It's not my job to tell you whether there's room or not. My job is to pick you up." There were 4 people that I knew really well at the front of the line, and 2 of them came and got me. I was like way to the back. And 2 came and got me and said, "You need to come up front. You're doing chemotherapy. You're really sick. You need to come to the front of the line." And as I started coming to the front of the line, one of the National Guards ejected all 3 of us. I spent that night under a lifeguard stand along Santa Monica Beach, just trying to shelter myself from the rain, trying to not get any more wet than I already was, trying not to freeze to death. There were some points when the rain would ease up a bit. But for the most part, all night long, it was a steady rain. And as the night wore on, the rain came down more And even underneath the lifeguard stand, there was no place for me to stay dry. The winds were blowing. So with the winds blowing, it just... So I guess it was about 4:30 in the morning. I just began to walk. My backpack was so drenched. I was drenched. I was covered in sand. I remember that night because I started to cry and I just said, God, just get me through this. The next morning cleared a little bit. If you live here in Southern California, you know our rainy days don't last very long. Cleared up, and I was sitting on the little wall right near Ocean Park and Nielsen Way. There's like a little step-up wall. I had my hands, my face, in my hands like that. I was still freezing. And I just remember the sun breaking through the clouds. And I could feel the warmth on my face. Finally, the little truck came by and I saw two guys get out and they opened up the bathroom. And I grabbed my wet stuff in my backpack and went into the bathroom and just stood in front of the dryer trying to get warm with the sopping wet clothes on. And at some point I said to myself, you know what, there's really no use. These clothes aren't gonna dry in front of this dryer. So there just isn't any use. And the clothes that I had in my backpack were already wet as well. Now my laptop and digital camera was in there and I just thought to myself, I hope it didn't get too wet. I hope it didn't get so wet that my communication to the outside world is gone. Guess the reason I couldn't sleep usually is it seems like since I've been back inside, and when I say inside, no longer homeless, rainy nights just don't seem the same to me. I remember before, I loved rainy nights. I would sleep so good. I would sleep so well. They just don't seem the same to me anymore. Because I'm thinking about homeless people who, for one reason or another, don't get into a shelter, don't get into a cold weather shelter once they open, and they're left to brave that rain. This might sound strange, but I always admired how even in all that pouring down rain, some homeless people would just lay down and go to sleep with all that rain beating down on them. And when I say I admired it because nights where I had to stay in the rain, I was so tired, so worn out. Rainy nights just haven't been the same for me. And I'm sure they never will be. Peace and blessings, everybody. Bye-bye.